is Nasser El-Hout. Basically, my background, I studied computer engineering and computer science a few years back. I've been involved in COBIT since version 3. I was involved in the revision for the draft for COBIT5. I'm also an ITIL expert. I work with the field of training, consulting, standards, frameworks, best practices, governance. Just basically, that's what I do. And I do a lot of training as well as consulting assignments in the region. I've done training from Tokyo to Lagos and almost everywhere in between. So in brief, this is what I do. To put it briefly, COBIT5 is simply guidance about how to have proper governance over your IT. This is in short. And we want to talk about governance. I mean, I like to summarize it in two words: direct and control. Organizations want to make sure that they are getting value out of their IT, that their IT is actually supporting their strategic objectives because of the importance of IT. IT is simply more than just infrastructure management. IT has to be elevated to the level of becoming a strategic partner for the business. And this is the importance of having such a full and comprehensive governance framework in place. And COBIT5 actually delivers that framework. It's a very comprehensive framework that will support the business to achieve whatever it wants to achieve from IT. For the past few years, companies in the Middle East have been focusing simply on running IT. But IT, as I said before, is more than simply infrastructure management. They have to make sure that IT is aligned with the needs of the business. They want to make sure that they are getting the value from IT that they expect to get. It's not simply a black box where we throw money in and we don't know what we're getting out of it. With the introduction of the reliance on IT, there's more and more risk that is associated with IT. We want to ensure that we have regulatory compliance. We're complying with international laws and regulations. And that's why adopting such a framework is very important for organizations in the Middle East. In some of the countries around us, the use of COBIT has been actually mandated by governments. In Turkey, for instance, the use of COBIT has been mandated by the central bank. So any bank that wants to operate in Turkey, which is a rapidly expanding economy, they have to use COBIT guidance. So sometimes there is no choice about this. They have to. Many people think COBIT is just for IT, which is actually not. When we talk about relationship between business and IT, there's something in it for business and there's something in it for IT. There's something in COBIT for everybody, for business, for board level, for management, for IT management, for IT audit, for risk, for assurance. So there is something in COBIT for everybody. It's not just for IT. And that is the conception that has been had for quite some time. It's just an IT framework, which is not. First and foremost, COBIT5 is a business framework. The main topics that we talk about the principles of COBIT, for COBIT5, the key enablers that we have in COBIT5. We focus a lot on some of the tools and some of the practical guidance that is available in COBIT5. How to do process assessments, what's the implementation approach for COBIT5, all of these are covered in the foundation course of COBIT5. The nice thing about it, with 2 or 3 days of taking this foundation course, you actually have practical guidance that you can take and start using in your organization. So the return on investment for this course is very quick. Well, we do a lot of PowerPoint presentations. We also do a lot of we have case studies in the training. So we do have a lot of practical exercises. And we're just basically, it's a combination of sharing experiences. So it's a very interactive and lively approach. It's not just death by PowerPoint. That's not what we look for. So we share experiences, we have case studies, exercises. And in some particular instances, we combine the training with simulations, business simulations, which actually gives the candidates hands-on experience on how to actually cover some of the challenges that face them in implementation that are not covered in the field. Actually, those business simulations are extremely valuable. Those are role-playing exercises where we assign different roles to the individuals, to different individuals that are participating in these simulations. And they actually have hands-on experience regarding particular challenges. Some of these simulations are internationally accredited simulations. For instance, the Apollo 13 that we are bundling with this or introducing with this course was based on the actual case of Apollo 13. And the person that actually developed this game sat down with the NASA people, with the astronauts, to actually develop this simulation, which gives a lot of value. to the candidates, and at the same time it gets them involved. It helps you understand the capabilities of different individuals, the attitudes. You see some people standing up, taking authority, taking control, and others just are like a deer caught in a headlight. So it helps you also assess the individuals in the organization. So those are great tools that you can use. Since the introduction of COBIT5, we have seen great demand in the for COBIT5 certified individuals. The COBIT5 Foundation certificate will prepare them to take more advanced courses, the COBIT implementation or the COBIT assessor or COBIT for NIST security. But the more important about this, it also provides them with practical guidance about implementing IT governance within their own organization. So on a personal level, there is great value for it. There is demand for COBIT certified individuals, and this demand is set to grow because ISACA and AKMG are creating a full certification scheme around COBIT5, and we have seen this growth in this region. So on a personal level it's important, on an organizational level it's important, on a country-based level it is important because it is being mandated in some countries. In Saudi Arabia there is even talk now that different governmental organizations will be required to use COBIT guidance. So there is going to be huge. We have seen the demand, and the demand is going to continue for COBIT. We have two objectives out of this course. Let the candidates familiar with COBIT5 and what COBIT5 can do for them. And at the same time, we want to help them to prepare them for the exam in order to pass the exam. So the exam will be offered as part of this training, because this is accredited training.